Hellbaker that I told him all that I know already. Tell him I want to live in peace, understand? There is no use to go on tormenting me. I know nothing at all about that case of coins. Now that gold has disappeared, but if he'd listened, we could have avoided this altogether. I went to the army court. There were no witnesses. They couldn't uncover any more. I can't tell Baker what happened to the money. Go back and tell him that.
Word's around you had a visitor. And Baker knows it. Name it Jackson. Well, Jackson was here. Or Baker's got it all wrong.
He's not wrong.
Maybe Baker would like to know just what you and Jackson had to say about the cash box. That's not what I'm being paid for. I'm only interested in what name Jackson's hiding under now.
Why do you think Jackson may be assuming another name?
I would have found him already. When I start off to find somebody, I find them. That's why they pay me.
Why is Baker paying you?
That's your family?
Yes.
Nice family.
What does he pay you for murdering me?
$500 to get the name. The name.
Carson. Bill Carson. That's what he calls himself now.
$1,000 and some in gold. It's a tidy sum. But when I'm paid, I always see the job through.
You. Any information?
Too much. You said quite a bit that should interest you. And one or two things that interested me.
Such as?
The name Jackson's hiding under is Bill Carson. That's your bid.
Keep talking.
He also mentioned something about a certain cash box, which just happened to disappear. That's my bid.
Anything else?
Not enough for you, eh? Well, you don't have to worry. He'll never say anything to anybody again.
Oh, yeah. Perfect. Here you are. Here, this is for you. You did a good job for me. Worth $500.
Yeah. Almost forgot. He gave me $1,000. I think his idea was that I kill you. But you know the pity is when I'm paid. I always follow my job through. You know that.
No! Angel Iron!
Pistol, amigo. It won't do you any good. There are three of us.
Hey, amigo. You know you've got a face beautiful enough to be worth $2,000?
Yeah. But you don't look like the one who collected. A couple steps back.
Thank you.
How much are you worth now?
How much? $2,000.
That's right. $2,000.
Yeah. $2,000.
Hijo de puta que te parió! You pay for this? I hope you end up in a graveyard with the cholera and the rabies and the plague. Cut me loose! Cut me loose, you fucking bastard! Put me down! I hope your mother ends up in a two-lala house. Cut me loose! Cut me loose! You can still save yourself. Let me go and I'll pardon you. Let me go!
I feel sick. The blood is pushing to my... I'm dry, man. Aqua. Water.
You snake! You son of a bitch! Let me go! You pray with the man who's tied up! Come back! Come back and fight! Bastard! Who the hell is that? One bastard goes in, another comes out.
Cut it out!
I'm honest, farmer! I'm innocent of everything!
So you're an honest farmer. You recognize this man?
Me?
Yeah, it's you.
Me? Who says so? You can't even read. Roll it up! Roll it up! I'll give you a good idea where you can put it. The hell with all you sheriffs and deputies and all who give birth to you. Hey, everybody, look, look! He's giving him the filthy money! Judas, you sold my hide! But you won't enjoy any of that money, not a penny. If there's justice in the world, that money will go to the undertakers. Every penny of it, huh? You know who you are, huh? Huh? You want to know whose son you are? You don't, I do, everybody does. You're the son of 1,000 fathers, all bastards like you. And your mother, she's... You bastard! Your mother, it's better not to talk about! I never hurt anybody!
Wanted in 14 counties of this state, the condemned is found guilty of the crimes of murder, armed robbery of citizens, state banks, and post offices, the theft of sacred objects, arson in a state prison, perjury, bigamy, deserting his wife and children, inciting prostitution, kidnapping, extortion, receiving stolen goods, selling stolen goods, passing counterfeit money, and contrary to the laws of this state, the condemned is guilty of using marked cards and loaded dice. Therefore, according to the powers vested in us, we sentence the accused here before us, Chuco Benedicto Pacifico Juan Maria Ramirez,
known as the Rat,
and any other aliases you might have, to hang by the neck until dead. May God have mercy on his soul. Proceed.
Five for you, and five for me. Know how much you're worth now?
No, how much?
$3,000.
There are two kinds of people in the world, my friend. Those with a rope around their neck and the people who have the job of doing the cutting. Listen, the neck at the end of the rope is mine. I run the risks. So the next time I want more than half.
You may run the risks, my friend, but I do the cutting. If we cut down my percentage. Cigar? Liable to interfere with my aim.
But if you miss, you had better miss very well. Whoever double-crosses me and leaves me alive, he understands nothing about Tuco. Nothing.
Wanted in 15 counties of this state. The condemned standing before us, sitting before us, Hugo Benedicto Pacifico Juan Maria Ramirez, has been found guilty by the 3rd District Circuit Court of the following crimes: murder, assaulting a justice of the peace, raping a virgin of the white race, statutory rape of a minor of the black race. Derailing a train in order to rob the passenger.
Angel Eye!
Bank robbery, highway robbery. Robbing an unknown number of post offices. Breaking out of...
What'd you find out, Shorty?
If you ask me, it seems like a book. An armed unit escorting a cash box of gold coins meets a Yankee ambush, and only three of them are saved. Stevens, Baker, and Jackson. The thing that wasn't saved, though, was the coins. But then the army decides, of course, it ought to hold a hearing and Jackson's acquitted. He disappears and becomes Bill Carson.
I know his name.
But you don't know just who you're looking for, and I do. And when he's found, I'd be scared to be put in his shoes.
Where is Carson?
All I know is Carson re-enlisted. The poor guy's minus an eye. He lives with a girl called Maria, who'll tell you. She's a fresh young whore in the territory.
Where's she?
Now, what's the name of that town? Someplace fairly near. Santa Ana.
Adios, half soldier.
Hey, Luke, hand me down a whiskey.
And the sheriff's office in Sonora. Then hired himself out as guide to a wagon train. After receiving his payment in advance, deserted the wagon train on the hunting grounds of the Sioux Indians.
Glad they got him. A man guilty of all those crimes.
People with ropes around their necks don't always hang.
What do you mean?
Even a filthy beggar like that has got a protecting angel. A golden-haired angel watches over him.
From the Union Army. For all these crimes, the accused has made a full, spontaneous confession. Therefore, we condemn him to be hung by the neck until dead. May the Lord have mercy on his soul. Proceed.
Anybody can miss a shot. Nobody misses when I'm at the end of the rope. You never had a rope around your neck. Well, I'm going to tell you something. When that rope starts to pull tight, you can feel the devil bite your ass.
Yeah, you're right. It's getting tougher. The way I figure, there's really not too much future with a sawed-off runt like you.
What do you mean?
Because I don't think you'll ever be worth more than $3,000.
What do you mean?
I mean, our partnership is untied. Oh, no.
Wait.
Not you. You remain tied. I'll keep the money and you can have the rope.
You filthy double-crossing bastard of all the stinking dirty tricks.
Way back to town is only 70 miles. Now, if you save your breath, I feel a man like you could manage it. Adios.
You filthy bastard! Come here! Come here! Cut this rope off! Get off that horse! Get off that horse! You filthy cunt! If I ever cut you, Blondie, I'll rip your heart out and eat it! I'll skin you alive! I'll hang you by your thumb! You pig! You vulture! I'll kill you! I'll kill you!
Such ingratitude after all the times I've saved your life.
Come back! Wait, Blondie! Listen, Blondie! Hijo de una gran puta!
Is that you, Bill? Bill!
go on talking about Bill Carson.
I don't know.
You were calling to him in the dark? Where is he?
What are you going to do to...
I'll ask the questions. Where is he?
This unit. They all left.
Which company? Where'd they go?
Third Cavalry. General Sibley. He left for Santa Fe. That's all I know. I swear.
I'm very sorry, but the store's closing.
Revolvers.
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 Well, here's where I keep the best ones. Here, Remington, Colt, Root, Smith Wesson, Colt, Navy, Jocelyn, another Remington. And this
That's
one
enough. Cartridges.
You want to try the pistol? Just step out
Let's
back.
Go. Good. cartridge. How much? $20. No. $50.
How much?
$100. $200. It's all I've got.
If you work for a living, why do you kill yourself working? If you work for a living, why do you kill yourself working? Gotta be poor to eat potatoes. Really poor. I'm rich, but I'm lonely. The world is divided into two parts. Those who have friends, and those who are lonely like Potuco. You see? I used to have a friend, Pedro. Chico and Ramon, his two brothers, were my friends too. But who knows where they are now? That's too bad, friends. Tough luck I haven't found you. I had a good deal for you. There's a big son of a bitch who's got $4,000. $4,000. And I know where to find it. If they would help me catch him, I'd divide it four ways, like a brother. $1,000 each.
You're alive, Tuco. Is it true?
Rich, like you're going to be.
But people are saying you got killed in Albuquerque.
And people talk bullshit. I'm alive, you bastards, and I always will be. And I've come to give you $3,000. Vamos.
He's closing in with his northerners, and no later than tomorrow that they'll be in the city. That's when these southerners are getting out. You see, as soon as these cowards hear of blue shirts around, they run. These rebels have no will to fight.
Poor things.
They'll soon be finished. If we get rid of these bastards, then we begin making money on those Yankees. They carry gold, not paper dollars. And they're going to beat the South. Look. See that one with a white beard sitting in the wagon? General Sibley. He looks dead.
He's finally getting out of our hair. Hooray for Dixie! Hooray! Hooray for Dixie!
Where's the owner of that horse?
Please, mister, sir, a bad heart. Where? The war's frightened me already.
I'm looking for the owner of that horse. He's tall, blonde, he smokes his cigar, and he's a pig. Where is he now?
You leave him be. He doesn't know who rides every horse.
You stay quiet, old hen.
Upstairs. Upstairs in room four, senor.
Hear that?
You rotten criminals, how dare you?
Spurs.
There are two kinds of spurs, my friend. Those that come in by the door, those that come in by the window. Take off that pistol belt.
It's empty.
Mine isn't. Even when Judas hanged himself, there was a storm, too.
That could be cannon fire.
Cannon fire or storm, it's all the same to you. You ever see this before, my friend? Throw it over the roof beam. That's it. Now get on that. That's right. Now make sure the rope is tight. Got to hold the weight of a pig. Now put the rope around your neck. That's very good. It's too big for your neck, huh? We fix that right away. I have another system, a little different than yours. I don't shoot the rope. I shoot the legs off the stool. Adios.
Thank you. welcome, my friend. If you're looking for a summer vacation spot, you found it. Our hotel is luxurious and filled with conveniences. And the attractions don't stop there. International cuisine. Healthful and nutritious food. Corn cobs. Dixie style. Our government has spared no expense. As you can see, we are treated very well.
Have you ever heard of anyone by the name of Bill Carson?
And you? Have you ever heard of someone named Canby? No? Well, you see, he's a Yankee colonel who decided to tear us to pieces. The only thing we care about is saving our own hides. And you ask me if I know some. I just don't know what you drifters could be thinking.
Carson has a patch over one eye. He's with the third.
If he's with the third, they've already left. For Glorieta. Canby's front line is right on their heels, those poor young devils. And the desert lies ahead of them. I really doubt that any of them are still alive.
And what if they were still alive?
Worse. Well then, you must not have heard anything about Batterville. It's one of those Yankee prison camps. You'd better hope you never end up in.
Keep it, it's yours.
Guilty of the following crimes: horse theft, theft of supplies belonging to the Union Army, theft of supplies belonging to the Confederate Army, wounding two vigilantes, assault and battery on one named Barry O'Keefe, perjury, blackmail, robbery, escaping from a state prison, disturbing the peace, pandering,
and Shorty.
Sorry, Shorty.
let's go.
The desert, I'm thirsty.
Burns, huh? They say people with fair skin can't take too much.
Where are we going?
Where I'm going, amigo. Over that way, another 100 miles of beautiful sun-baked sand. Even the armies are afraid to march through there.
Sibley's men are retreating up there. Cambi's men are coming here.
But no one will set foot in this hell. Except you and me.
100 miles. That's a nice walk.
What was it you told me the last time?
If you save your breath, I feel a man like you could manage it. And if you won't manage it, you'll die. Only slowly. Very slowly, old friend. After you, please. Start walking. We don't have very far to go. Only 70 miles. Only 8.5 hours more before sunset. That's not too bad. Come on. Ha, 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 ha.
Okay, let's eat. That is, I'll eat. Huh? Meanwhile, you can enjoy a sunbath.
You want some water?
Drink, drink. Come on, come on. Well, Blondie, so long.
And so, Blondie, it's goodbye.
Thank you.
200,000 in gold. The odds just get me water.
Huh? What's that you say? Who the hell are you?
Carson. My name is Bill Carson now. It's Carson. Surprise attack. Oh, Dad. My name is Jackson. No? Carson.
Yeah. Glad to meet you, Carson. I'm Lincoln's grandfather. What was that you said about the dollars?
200,000, oh man. Was the 3rd Cavalry's. Baker has nothing. The gold. I hid the gold. The gold is safe.
Where? Where? Here? Here? Talk. Here. Huh?
Cemetery.
Which cemetery?
The one. On Sand Hill. There.
Which grave? Have a name? Have a number? Come on, you dummy, talk.
Yeah. There's no number. Yeah. There's a name.
Huh?
It's written.
This?
Water.
You talk first, huh? I'll give you water later. Sad Hill Cemetery, okay. In the grave, okay. But it must have a name or a number on it. It must be 1,000, 5,000. You. Don't die, I'll get you water. Stay there. Don't move, I'll get you water. Don't die until later.
Just like the greasy rat that you are. If I were you, I'd keep me alive.
What did he tell you?
A name on a grave.
What name?
Don't die, Blondie. Don't die. I'm your friend. Please don't die. Please. I'm your friend. Come on. Come on.
Blondie, I'll help you. Don't move. I'll be right back. I'll get the water. Don't die like that pig. Blondie, water. Water, Blondie. Don't drink. It's no good for you. Feel better? Blondie, what's the matter? Please don't die.
Hey, open up! Open up!
Settle down. Who's there?
Who do you mean, who's there? You think I'm the enemy? If I were a Yankee, you wouldn't have time to ask me that. Come on!
Sergeant, listen to this corporal for a moment.
Yes, sir. Sergeant, I have a gravely wounded man here, if he's not dead already. He's still alive?
Well, he seems to be. What happened?
It was a trap. Only the two of us got away.
Name and traveling papers.
Here, Corporal Bill Cossack, 3rd Regiment, 2nd Cavalry Squadron, arriving from San Rafael. Is that enough? You're reading? Well, this man is dying.
But, Corporal, we're trying to withdraw, and you're looking for an infirmary? If you want one, you'll have to make yourself a Yankee prisoner.
So where are we?
We're near Apache Canyon.
Apache Canyon?
Apache Canyon.
Isn't Mission San Antonio around here?
Sure, 18 miles south. Take him there. The brothers take care of anyone who's wounded, no matter what the color of his uniform. And keep your eyes open. The area's full of Yankees.
Thank you. Goodbye, Sergeant.
Take care.
Here.
But we have no more beds here.
Where am I of yours? Where's Padre Ramirez?
Padre Ramirez. He's away at the moment. He should be back any day now.
Well, it doesn't matter. For the moment, we take very good care of my friend. And may God be praised. In case you didn't know, God is on our side, too. Because he hates the Yanks. Huh, Blondie? Father, is he still breathing?
Yes, of course.
God, you're heavy. Father, did he speak? Did he say anything? Oh,
Father, did he ask for me? Did he speak about anything, Father?
Oh, no, he hasn't spoken as yet. But you mustn't worry. He's both young and strong. That's what's kept him going until now. He should regain his strength in a very short time.
Thank you, Father, thank you. You don't know much this boy's life means to me. Thanks be to Jesus. Thanks to all of you. Hey, Blondie. Hey, the old father tells me you'll be up and around in a few days. You're very lucky to have me so close when it happened. Think if you've been on your own. Look, I mean when one is ill, it's good to have somebody close by, friends or relations. Do you have parents, Blondie? A mother?
Not even a mother. No one. You're all alone, huh?
Like me, Blondie. We're all alone in the world. I have you, you have me.
Only for a little while, I mean.
It had to happen now. What a dirty, rotten trick of fate. We could have all that money in our hands. I must tell you the truth, Blondie. In my place, you would do the same thing. It's all over for you now. There's nothing anyone can do anymore. Oh, God, look at me. It's my fault. Mine.
I'll tell you one thing, Blondie.
If I knew that my last hour had come, I swear... In my place, in your place, I would do the same thing. I would tell about the gold. Yes, I would. I'd tell the name on the grave. After all, what good is the money to you if you're dead? I know the name of the cemetery, but you know how many graves there are there. Please. Blood, please, have a little. Coffee, please, tell me the name. On the grave. If I get my hands on the $200,000, I'll always honor your memory. I swear, I'll always honor your memory.
Come closer.
Tell me. You dirty bush.
I'll sleep better knowing my good friend is by my side to protect me.
Duco, water. Where's water? But if I get that name from you, I'll give you water. All right, you dirty skunk. Get your ass off the bed. Come on, the party's over. The wagon is all ready to go.
From the way the wounded are pouring into this place, we'd better get the hell out of here before we get caught up in the war.
Look, Father Ramirez is back.
Oh, yeah. This is something I have to look into. It'll only take a minute. Get moving. Where? This way?
Yes.
Hey, Pablo? Don't you recognize me? It's me, Tuco. Let me embrace you. I don't know the right thing. I was just passing by here. I said to myself, I wonder if my brother remembers his brother. Did I do wrong? It doesn't matter. I'm very happy.
You've seen me, Tuco.
Yeah, well, I'm very glad I came. Oh, my uniform! It's a long story. But let's talk about you. It's more important. You look very well. A bit thin, perhaps, but... You were always thin, eh, Pablito? What about our parents?
Only now do you think of them. To begin after 9 years.
9 years? So it's 9 years. 9 years!
Our mother has been dead a long time now. Our father died only a few days ago. That's why I was away. He asked for you to be there. But there was only me. And you. Outside of evil, what else have you managed to do? It seems to me you once had a wife someplace.
Not one, lots of them. One here, one there, wherever I found. Go on, preach me a sermon, Pablo.
What good would that be? Just keep on the way you're going. Go away. And the Lord have mercy on your soul.
Sure, I'll go, while I'm waiting for the Lord to remember me. I, Tuco Ramirez, brother of brother Ramirez, will tell you something. You think you're better than I am. Where we came from, if one did not want to die of poverty, one became a priest or a bandit. You chose your way, I chose mine. Mine was harder. You talk of our mother and father. You remember when you left to become a priest. I stayed behind. I must have been 10, 12, I don't remember which, but I stayed. I tried, but it was no good. Now I'm going to tell you something. You became a priest because you were too much of a coward to do what I do.
Tuco. Please forgive me, brother.
Nice guy, my brother. I didn't tell you my brother was in charge here. Everything, like the Pope almost. He's in charge in Rome.
Yeah, yeah, my brother, he say to me, stay, brother, don't go home. We never see each other. Here there's plenty to eat and drink. Bring your friend, too. Whenever we see each other, he never lets me go. It's always the same story. My brother is crazy about me.
That's so. Even a tramp like me, no matter what happens. I know there's a brother somewhere who'll never refuse me a bowl of soup.
Sure. Well, after a meal, there's nothing like a good cigar.
Sierra Madalena. Going this way, we cross the Rio Grande. Hey, that sure is a long way. Here to the northwest, through all of Texas. Huh? Well, after that...
Then what?
Then we get there, I'll tell you. You're not worried, are you?
Those men aren't worried about anything anymore, are they? But since I'm alive, and I've noticed we'll be crossing Yankee and Confederate lines a few times, I thought you might tell me where we're going.
Towards $200,000. Is that good enough for you?
Them and then get going. Hurrah! Hurrah for the Confederacy! Hurrah! Down with General Grant! Hurrah for General... What's his name?
Lee!
Hey! God is with us because he hates the Angstall! Hurrah!
God's not on our side because he hates idiots also.
Thank you.
Robert Clark.
Present.
Sam Richmond.
Present.
Bill Carson. Bill Carson? I said Bill Carson.
Hey, Blondie, isn't that Angel Eyes?
All right, what's he doing? Sleeping? Bill Carson!
Yeah, and you better be Bill Carson.
Bill Carson!
That's me.
Please, Carson. Answer present.
What are you doing?
Suppose you say present, Carson.
I like big fat men like you. When they fall, they make more noise. And sometimes they never get up.
Wallace. That's enough.
Sergeant. The captain wants to see you right away.
Be sure these two get good treatment.
Hey, Blondie, did you hear that? Good treatment.
Yeah.
For the last time, Sergeant, I'm telling you, I want the prisoners treated as prisoners. No more brutality.
There's hundreds of prisoners out there and only a few men to guard them. Now, what am I supposed to do? I have to have respect.
I think that you'll manage to gain the respect by treating them better.
Are our men treated that well in Andersonville camp?
I don't give a goddamn what they do in Andersonville. While I'm in charge here, the prisoners are not to be tortured or cheated or murdered.
Is that an accusation?
Sergeant, gangrene is eating my leg away, not my eyes. I know the prisoners here are being robbed systematically. I know there's scum around who are bivouacked near the camp, waiting for someone to deliver this loot. But as long as I'm commandant, I won't permit any such trickery. Am I clear?
Yes, sir. Just as long as you're the commandant.
Yes, Sergeant. I know this leg means I won't last very long. But I pray I can manage to have enough time to amass evidence and bring to a court-martial all those who discredit and dishonor the uniform of the Union.
I wish you luck. Better lay low for a few days. I'll keep this. You go. Wallace will let you know. Wallace. Bring me Carson.
Close enough to keep an eye on things. Come on, saddle your horses.
Get in. Come on in, Tuco.
Don't be bashful. There's no formalities here.
It's been a long time. You're hungry. Sit down. Eat.
I knew it. When I saw you, I said to myself, look at that big angel eyes. I bet he got himself an easy job. And he never forgets a friend.
I never forget old friends, Tuco.
Right.
It's good to see old friends again.
Good.
Especially when they've come from so far away. And have so much to talk about.
Mm-hmm.
And you do have a lot to talk about, haven't you?
Mm-hmm.
You were captured near, Fort Craig.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. Well, if you were with Sibley, that means then that you, were coming from Santa Fe.
Mm-hmm.
Was it hard crossing the desert?
Mm-hmm. Very hard. Especially if you don't have anything to drink.
Why are you going under the name of Bill Carson now?
One name is as good as another. Not wise to use your own name. Like you. I bet they don't call you Angel Eyes. Sergeant Angel Eyes.
Like a little music with your meal, Tuco?
Music? Yes, it's very good. Very good for the digestion.
So, Bill Carson's a fake name, huh? A fake, too?
Bill Carson's name's written on it. Have some. It's Bill Carson's tobacco. Carson dead or alive when we found him? What did he tell you about the money?
I don't know what you're talking about.
Consider yourself much luckier than your pal. Wallace will punch your friend as long as the song goes. So many of us have had a session in there.
He knows the name of the grave.
$200,000. I know the name of the cemetery now. And you know the name of the grave.
Give me the same treatment?
Would you talk?
No, probably not.
That's what I thought. Not that you're any tougher than Tuco, but you're smart enough to know that talking won't save you.
And Tuco, is he...
Mm-mm. No. Not yet. But he's in very good hands. You've changed partners, but you still got the same deal. I'm not greedy. I'm only taking half.
there's two of us. Should make it easier than just one.
Yeah.
Afraid he'll get lost. Where's the rebel going?
To hell with a rope around his neck and a price on his head.
Yeah. $3,000, friend. That's a lot of money for a head. I bet they didn't even pay you a penny for your arm. I told you once, friend, if I ever get you down, you're gonna need a lot of help to get up again. All right.
You're a lot luckier than that one there. You get some grub, a rope, when you're all finished. And there isn't any partner this time to shoot you down.
Your friends stay out in the damp. They're liable to catch a cold, aren't they? Or a bullet.
Hear that, boys? Come on out here.
Since we're all going in the same direction, might as well go together. One, two, three, four, five, six, six. Perfect number.
Isn't three the perfect number?
Yeah, I got six more bullets in my gun.
Thank you. Sure would like to put your paw on it, huh?
I would like to face this rough. I've been shaking up in this train nearly 10 hours now.
You smell like a pig already. But let's try not to make things any worse. Get going.
I can't while you're watching me.
Thank you. I've been looking for you for 8 months. Whenever I should have had a gun in my right hand, I thought of you. Now I find you in exactly the position that suits me. I had lots of time to learn how to shoot with my left.
When you have to shoot, shoot, don't talk.
Every gun makes its own tune. And it's perfect timing, large one. On and take your gun off.
Hey, Blondie, how the hell did you get out of that pigsty?
My own way. I'm here with your old friend, Angel Eyes.
You talked, you traitor. You talked.
No, I didn't talk. If I did, I probably wouldn't be here now.
You? Me? So only you know you have the secret?
Mm-hmm.
Blondie, I'm very happy you're working with me. And we're together again. I get dressed, I kill him, be right back.
Oh, listen, I forgot to mention. He's not alone. There's five of them.
Five?
Yeah, five of them.
So that's why you came to Tuco. It doesn't matter. I'll kill them all.
Shot him at close range. Well, look who's here.
The other one will be along.
They'll come looking for us. Watch out. There's two of them. I want that blonde alive.
You back there? Come on, let's go.
you're gonna die alone?
Hey, Blondie. Angel Eyes is mine, huh?
All right.
Soon.
Idiots.
Hmm?
It's for you.
Peaceful and quiet, amigo.
Like a cemetery, for instance?
There should be a bridge across that river.
We better wait for nightfall.
Trust in me, Blondie. I got a good sense of where I'm going. Tuco has taken you this far. I will take you all the way.
Telecap.
Yes, sir.
Come along now. Follow me.
Near the perimeter, sir.
Where do you hail from?
Illinois.
And you?
I'm with him.
Any reason for being around here?
We want to enlist, General.
You better learn to distinguish rank. I'm a captain. Get the hell out. Sure as hell might be you today, so go right your will.
Yes, sir.
So you want to enlist. You gotta take a test to prove it. Well, show me. You've got a career. At the least, I'd say you'll make colonel.
Really?
Sure. Like it says in the manual. You've got every qualification to become an expert in the use of weapons. But this, sir, is the most potent weapon in war. The fighting spirits in this bottle. Volunteers. You want to enlist? Let's go. Come on, Jack. Come on. Shooting hasn't begun yet.
Whoever has the most liquor to get the soldiers drunk and send them to be slaughtered, he's the winner. We and the ones over on the other side of the river only have one thing in common. All of us regal alcohol. What did you say your name was? And you? Names don't matter.
Yes, because soon you can join the Gallant Heroes for Branston Bridge. We have two attacks a day.
Two attacks a day?
Sure. The Rebs have decided that damn bridge is the key to this whole area. Stupid, useless bridge. Flyspike on headquarters maps. The headquarters has declared we must take that ridiculous flyspeck. Even if all of us are killed. Otherwise, the key will get rusty and just be a spot on a wall. And that's not all. Both sides want the bridge intact. Intact is how the South wants it. And we want it intact, too. You'll all turn to dust. But one thing is sure, boy. Branston Bridge will stand unbroken. Is it bad to speak the way I do to volunteers? I've done a lot worse. I've done it. I've blown it up.
Boom!
In here, I've destroyed it all. It's a court-martial offense to imagine, to dream of blowing it up. A serious crime. Even to think of destroying that bridge is just...
Why not really blow it up, Captain?
Yeah, Captain, it's nothing. Let's get the hell out of them.
I've been dreaming about it. I've even worked out a plan. I sure have. The best time.
after the attack. When there's a truce, to get the wounded. If I could do it, I could save many thousands of men. But what I like is the guts. The beginning of the daily slaughter right on time.
Captain, all companies are waiting your orders.
Be right there. Let's go.
All right, friends.
Come along and enjoy the spectacle.
It's really going to be a good, long battle.
Blondie?
Huh?
The money's on the other side of the river.
Oh? Where?
Amigo, I said the other side, and that's enough. But while the Confederates are there, we can't get across.
What would happen if somebody were to blow up that bridge?
Yeah. And these idiots will go somewhere else to fight.
Maybe.
things ready.
Sling of this, Captain. Keep your ears
Hey, you realize we might be risking our lives?
Yeah. And if I get killed, you'll never get your hands on all that beautiful money.
Huh?
Yeah, Duco. Sure would be a pity.
Why don't we tell each other our half of the secret?
Why don't we?
You go first.
No, I think it's better that you start.
All right. The name of the cemetery is... Sad Hill, now it's your turn.
The name on the grave is... Arch Stanton.
Arch Stanton? Are you sure?
Yeah, sure, I'm sure.
lot easier with that. If you shoot me, you won't see a cent of that money.
Why?
I'll tell you why. Because there's nothing in there.
You son of a...
You thought I'd trust you? $1,000 is a lot of money. We're gonna have to earn it.
How?
I'll write the name on the bottom of this stone. My gun?
Thank you.
and get me killed. When's your loaded?
Last night. You see, in this world, there's two kinds of people, my friend. Those with loaded guns, and those who dig. You dig.
Where?
Here.
There's no name on it.
There's no name here either. You see, that's what Bill Carson told me. It was the grave marked unknown right beside Arch Stanton.
Huh?
Go ahead.
You're joking, Blondie. You wouldn't play a joke on me like that.
It's no joke. It's a rope, Tuco. I want you to stand up there and put your head in that noose. Well, now, seems just like old times. War for you. Four for me. Sorry, Tuco.
Blonde! Blonde!
Yeah.